Hello and welcome as Stocks Advisor again, and we would like to show you Terminix Global Holdings Incorporated, traded at New York Stock Exchange, ticker name TMX. Well, this is the rare situation of the ticker that is just ready to boost. It's ready to go high. It's a mixture of very nice bullish indicators, very nice bullish patterns. So really, really ready to buy and just buy call here. So let's do a quick analysis here to understand what's happening. Overall, you can see that the position was trading very well from the beginning of year with some volatilities here overall, showing the confidence interval or the interval where the price was always going through, being between 46.77 and somewhere around 51.31. So this means that whenever you would buy at the bottom of this level, you will be always able to go at the top of this level for the half year period. So it's really, really nice, a lot very good profit here. And then suddenly we saw from beginning of August the major decline in the form of the classical breakdown here was happening, also showing very interestingly the first decline candle really almost equal to this channel, the level that we just discussed, the confidence level, and the price was really declining. Also pushing RSI quite strongly downwards, meaning that a lot of new people were exiting, entering, and old people exiting with losses. And also MACD histogram was making really, really deep negative wave, also indicating there was a massive loss of money, of course, of profit for people who were sitting on top here and then selling gradually. Now we see indication of bottoming and that MACD histogram is about to recover. RSI is very low now, so, and it's low already long period, meaning that a lot of people entered. So you see the volume boost here, so it's exchange of back holders, meaning that there are many new people ready to wait, and this means that the price positive pressure, the push up pressure is increasing. And now we see the candle combination, which is extremely bullish. So you see this exponential like decline, and you see this white candle with some small upward shadow and big downward shadow. So it's extremely bullish. And just this pattern will attract tomorrow a lot of people because just the pattern itself is extremely bullish, and just on psychological, it should grow. Also, company is quite big, up to 5.4 billion market capitalization. So it's not just, let's say, a small company that can die on a news or one kind of catalyst effect, and it's quite strong. So the overall recovery should be really nice. The first line to go would be at least 46.77, you can say, and actually also you can see here this broken trend line, which also calls for return, and once it's there, actually should be quite nice return here as well. So with this being said, we can say that after the rebounds, the second level to recover would be about 49. This is kind of a midterm, but this might come with some volatility. So anyway, we need to wait at least for the first level, which would be around 46.77, a little bit maybe lower, but this would be the area where we are aiming at. And this would mean up to 10-15% profit taking. So this will allow us to make the profit taking note. Here it will be 10-15% profit taking. Once you can take it, really do it. Don't hesitate. Never actually hesitate to take your profit, re-enter if needed, but always take it in time. And then we can talk about how to buy through here. We need to demagnify a little bit to see lower levels, but you can see that there are very strong levels, actually also very close to 40. So whatever happens, it should not go much lower. So with our non-linear buying strategy, we should be quite safe here to trade. So first level to buy would be just within, let's say, the current high and low. And this would be around 41.36 and 42.64. So this would be the first level to buy through. We can make our call out here. So 41.36 to 42.64. So this is the first technical level, meaning the first rebounds is about to take place and we should be able to make the profit. Should we decline a little bit, very rare, still possible because there are still levels lower to support, which would be extremely strong, and I don't think we even go those levels, although a bit broader if this happens. This would be between 38 and 39.69. So this would be the second level to buy through, and we can make our second call out therefore here. So 36 to 39.69. A little bit broad channel here, a little bit broad level, but that's what it is. Also the volatility is here quite big, you can see. And the third level we usually keep for so-called risk mitigations due to negative catalyst. This is the level that we cannot expect, we don't expect, that's why we don't call it the third technical level, when the first two are technical levels indeed, meaning the levels that can be expected. So the third one is usually happens at kind of a doomsday scenario. Here, doomsday scenario kind of already took place, so we don't expect it at all, but we always keep as a tradition money for this if it happens, so because we don't want to take loss at the end of the trade and we would like to still exit with a profit since we don't do any stop loss strategies. And this would be in this case between 33.95 and actually 35.37 at the top. So we can write it as a third call out for ourselves and keep some money to buy the through. How to buy through, we will talk in a few seconds. And just to give again, as I always do in every video, a little bit explanation, why do we do this? Because we don't do any stop loss, but still the strategy that we follow is the strategy to exit either with a profit or with a draw. So we don't want to take any loss and we are okay to wait a little bit because we are trading through the daily candles, principal levels, without stop loss, so we don't want to buy time with money, which do people who do stop loss, which is okay if you are intraday, but if you are through day, let's say trader, and it's okay for you to wait a little bit and to take profit, then this is the way to trade. So these are three levels to buy with the profit taking 10-15%. And now how to buy through, because this is very bullish, so usually we advise 5 portions play, but here it will be more optimistic, 4 portions play, meaning that the money you'd like to play here can split in 4. Then you can buy with one portion the first level. If the price declines to the second level, you can buy with another one portion. And remaining two portions, you just keep it as a kind of a safety pillow. So you keep it for the third level, which is not expected at all. It's just some money that we keep just in case if something bad, really bad happens. And then actually should be really, really nice trade. Oh, I think I made a misprint here. It's 38. Sorry for that, not 36, the second level. So with this correction, now that's all fine, adjusted for TMX. Now you know how to trade with it. Overall, of course, very bullish. Another very interesting situation happening here is a delayed magic cross down, actually delayed double magic cross down, meaning that both moving averages, the faster ones, are pushing from the top, piercing from the top the slower ones here. You can see the situation formed here. Simultaneously, moving average 20 is hitting 50 and 20, 200, and 50 is hitting 200 from top, but the price already declined. This is so-called delayed magic cross, which in contrary to normal magic cross down, works as a bullish effect. So it will push the price up because the price actually already went down. So everything is very bullish here from technical point of view. Therefore, I really like this stock. I am actually already in the position by the end of the day. And yeah, if you like to enter, you might do it as well for opening by tomorrow. So with this being said, good luck with this one. And if you like this way of trading, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Press the bell button. This way you will not miss our new videos and new interesting discussions for US-based stocks. With this being said, good luck and see you at another episode of Stocks Advisor channel.